Hello friends, I'm Rashmi and today I'm going to talk about phrasal verb. Phrasal verb is the verb followed by preposition. Today I'm going to deal with the phrasal verb with blow. Before getting down to it, first we need to know the meaning of the verb blow when it comes alone without any preposition. Then it means expel air through lips. He took a deep breath and blew. That means he let the air out from his mouth forcefully. When blow is followed by any preposition, say out, it means to extinguish. He extinguished the fire. Now let's talk about the phrasal verb with blow. We have in common around 5 phrasal verbs with blow. Blow up, blow out, blow over, blow off, blow away. This time I have taken 9-11 theme in order to make you learn the meaning and usage of phrasal verbs with blow. All the sentences with blow is framed against the backdrop of 9-11 tragedy. We all know that on September 11, 2001, America became the victim of brutal attack of terrorists. As you can see from the pictures, the Twin Towers were destroyed by explosion. When anything is destroyed by explosion, we can use the phrasal verb blow up. The World Trade Center was blown up by terrorists. The magnitude of tragedy was so intense that the whole world stood by America and condemned the attack and went out their anger by coming out on roof with banners against terrorism. So, when you become angry or furious, you can use the phrasal verb blow up. Then there's a second meaning for the phrasal verb blow up. The first one was to destroy the explosion and the second one is to become angry. The world blew up as you witnessed the collapse of World Trade Center. Then there's third meaning for the phrasal verb blow up. It means to inflate, put the air inside something. When the balloon is blown up, it goes up in the sky. That means when you put the air inside the balloon or when you inflate the balloon, it goes up. Then there is fourth meaning. To make something enlarge, to larden something. Blow up the photograph to make the picture clear. So we have enlarged this photograph in order to make it clear. So blow up means to make something enlarge. So we have got 4 meanings for the phrasal verb blow up. The first one is destroy the explosion. Second one is to become angry. Third one is to inflate. And fourth one is to enlarge. Now you can see from the picture, after the Twin Towers being hit by aeroplanes, it started emitting fire. The fire started oozing out from the building, fire and smoke. So it had to be put out. So we needed fire extinguishers. The firefighters tried to blow out the fire emitting from the building. Blow out means to extinguish. We all know that around 6,000 people lost their lives and lot many lost their near ones. We have never forgiven the culprit, nor can we ever forget the tragedy. In memory of our neighbors who were lost in the terrorist attack on September 11, 2001, in memories of all those who lost their lives and those they left behind, 9-11 tragedy has blown over, but world has its memories lingering. Blow over here means to subside, wane, trouble comes to an end. So the trouble of 9-11 has come to an end. Long back it has come to an end, but its memories is still there in our mind. We have never forgotten it and nor we can ever forget. Blow off, to ignore, refuse to take notice of, to end relationship. Terrorism is a grave problem and the world can't blow it off. That means the world can't ignore it. Blow away is to defeat or kill. Terrorism is still threatening humanity and has to be blown away from its root. That means we cannot ignore it. We have to defeat terrorism. And now we have come to an end. Should not blow off the phrasal verbs.